हेलो स्टूडेंट, फ्रॉम टुडे ऑनवर्ड आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू क्लासिकल इलेक्ट्रोडायनामिक्स। सो लेट अस स्टार्ट विद द चैप्टर वन, दैट इज व्हाट इलेक्ट्रोस्टैटिक्स। सो इनिशियली आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन यू व्हाट इज मीन बाय इलेक्ट्रोस्टैटिक्स। सो स्टडी ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक चार्जेस एट रेस्ट इज नोन एज इलेक्ट्रोस्टैटिक्स। सो इन दिस चैप्टर वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी सम बेसिक लॉज। सो I am going to start with the first law, that is known as Coulomb's law. Charles Augustine Coulomb, whose duration is from 1736 to 1806, formulated the law of electric field between two stationary charged particles. And the statement of the law is explained here. The law states that the force of attraction or repulsion between two point charges at rest is directly proportional to the product of magnitude of charges and inversely proportional to the square of the distance between them and is along the line joining to them. So combining these two different statements, formulas, we have the force is directly proportional to the magnitude of charges, that is Q1 into Q2 divided by the square of the distance between them, that is R square. Or we can write this law as F is equal to beta into Q1 Q2 upon R square, where beta is Coulomb's constant. This beta, it depends on the unit and the nature of medium in which the charges are situated. Suppose if the charges are situated in a free space, then beta can be given as 1 upon 4 pi epsilon 0, where epsilon is permittivity of the free space. So let us move towards the next part of the law. So initially it is given the Coulomb's law in a free space, and SI unit is expressed as F is equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon 0 Q1 Q2 divided by R square. Experimentally, we find the values of epsilon 0 or epsilon naught as 8.854 into 10 raised to minus 12. Okay. Whereas 1 upon 4 pi epsilon 0 is equal to 8.98 into 10 raised to 9 or 9 into 10 raised to 9 newton meter square per coulomb square. Okay. Second, if the charges are situated in some other medium, then the Coulomb's law, which can be expressed in SI unit, is expressed as F is equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon Q1 Q2 upon R square, where epsilon is permittivity of the medium in the charges where the charges are situated. Now let us find out the relation between this epsilon naught and epsilon, and it is like this: epsilon is equal to K into epsilon naught, where K is what? Dielectric constant. As force and distance in equation 1 are the vector quantities, hence the Coulomb's law in vector form can be expressed as F12 is equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2 divided by R square. R21 is what? It is a unit vector. Okay. Now let us move towards the next part. Now see, as I told you, R21 is a unit vector, and by using triangle law, it can be calculated as, see, here, this is the origin, R1 and R2 are in this direction. So, R21 unit vector can be expressed as R21 divided by the magnitude, that is R21, mod of R21. This can be expressed as R21 divided by R. Okay, so putting the value of this unit vector in the previous equation, what is the previous equation? Which is given here, F21 is equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon 0 Q1 Q2 upon R square. So, I am going to put the value of R21 here. So, by putting that value, what you have, F 1 2 is equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught q1 q2 divided by r cube. Okay, and here you have this r21. Okay, similarly force acting on q2, now this is the force acting on q1. Okay, now I'm going to express the force acting on q2 due to q1, because it is force acting on q1 due to q2. Hence the force can be calculated like this: as it is acting on q2 due to q1, hence I am writing this as F21. Okay, it can be expressed as F21 is equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught q1 q2 upon r cube r12, here r21 because the force is acting on 1 due to q2, it is exactly reverse, hence I am writing here r21. So from equation 2 and 3 and this figure, we are going to summarize the force like this: F force acting on q1 due to q2 can be expressed as 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught q1 q2 into mod of r1 minus r2 bracket cube into the bracket r1 minus r2. Similarly, the force acting on q2 due to q1 can be expressed as 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught q1 q2 mod of r2 minus r1 cube and this one. Thus, by these two we get F21 means the force acting on q1 due to q2 is equal to the minus of force of acting on q2 due to q1. They have the relation like this. So now if we have a group of charges q1, q2, q3, qn situated at a point having a position vectors, that means it is like this. If these are the groups, okay, they are originated from this origin. Okay, these are the q1, q2, q3 up to qn with their position vectors r1, r2, r3, rn. Then the total force acting on a charge qi due to all other charges will be Fi is equal to Qi upon 4 pi max long naught summation of j is equal to 1, j is not equal to I, to n Qi divided by Rji into Rji. So this is the equation for the force which acting on Qi charge due to all other charges. So in short, what we learned, that I am going to summarize here. So today what we learn, that I am going to summarize in short. See, initially we saw Coulomb's law, which here the two charges are situated q1 q2, this is the force F21, this is the force F12 and this is F21, this is a unique vector. So what we learned today, that this force is directly proportional to the magnitude of q1 q2, inversely proportional to the distance between them. So finally we have the equation F is equal to 1 upon 4 epsilon naught q1 q2 upon r square into unit vector. Okay, so we can calculate. After that we saw the calculation for the force F21 and F12. So see here, after that I explain you triangular law, and by using this triangular law we calculate the unit vectors r12, and by putting that unit vector we calculate the generalized force qi. So with this I am going to stop. So let us meet for the next section.